Hey everybody, welcome to Farm Cooking with Nan. Today we are going to be doing, we're going to be making what Kim from Kimmy's Southern Cooking gave me this recipe. She sent me some and I loved it. And she gave me this recipe and I did this a long time ago. But this is something that I feel like needs to be brought back out again to show everybody because it's a great little Christmas gift to put in somebody's stocking or to just give somebody. It is called, she calls it spoon butter, is what she calls it. And I need my cutting board conditioned right now. So I'm gonna teach y'all how to make it, and I'm gonna get it in the oven, get it to going, and then I'm gonna show you how I work on my board, okay? So let's start out right here. I've just got a little jar. This is, I think, better than bouillon jar. Save you, these things are so cute and handy to save. But I'm going to double my recipe today because I want to, I want a lot for mine because I've got a big board. I need a lot of butter for mine. You know, spoon butter for mine. My little fingers ain't working this morning. Well, ain't no little, but okay. The recipe calls for 2 tablespoons of beeswax. I'm going to use more because I want to make more. It calls for 2 tablespoons. So I'm going to add 2 more for me, okay? I might triple that recipe. Like I said, this one's for me. This one I'm making for me because I'm out of it. Okay, let me show you what it is. This one's Beeswerks Yellow Beeswax is what this is. You can see right here what it looks like. The little round beeswax things. And I ordered this from Amazon. This will, if you're going to do gifts, this will do a lot of gifts. I heard my oven just warm up to 100. I think it's 160, it may be 170 degrees. My oven just warmed up to 170 degrees. Okay, the next, just 2 ingredients. The next thing I'm going to put in is 3 tablespoons of, this is MCT oil. This is a coconut oil. MCT oil, and this can be got from Amazon and from Walmart. MCT oil. I don't want nobody to me to jerk it down. See, it's 100% coconut source. Okay, I'm supposed to put in 3 tablespoons. The recipe calls for 2 tablespoons of beeswax. It calls for 3 tablespoons of the coconut oil. So, you know, I tripled my recipe, so I'm going to have to put, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm putting in 6 because remember, I tripled the recipe. Now, I don't want you to pay attention to what I did with mine. I want you to remember that this is 2 tablespoons of beeswax and 3 tablespoons of the MCT oil, the coconut. Now, and you'd say, Nan, can I use regular coconut? Listen, this recipe was given to me by somebody else. Like from Kim, from Kimmy's Southern Cooking. And Kimmy says, stick with the MCT oil. If you're going to make this for yourself or for somebody else that you're going to give away as gifts, don't skimp on it. It's not real expensive, believe me, it's not. And this will go a long, long ways. It'll make a lot. And if you get those little tiny canning jars with, you know, they're the smallest one. They're like, are they 2.5 ounce? I'm going to go ahead and put this in, okay? Because my oven just said it is ready. And I'm going to see. Now what? Place your your canning jar, which that's a canning jar, in the oven, and then put it on a baking pan and place an oven at 170 degrees for about 35 to 40 minutes. I'm gonna write that down because I'm doing some other things and I don't want to forget what time. So it's, I need to leave that in there, 35 to 40 minutes. It should come out about, let's see, it's 10:43. Plus, I'm gonna leave it the full 40 minutes, okay? This should come out. Takes me a while. Now that I've got that in the oven, now we're going to start doing, I'm gonna show you how I work on my board, because I already have some. Okay, I'm gonna show you. I have some left over from last time. That's the way it looks like when it's left over, okay? And I'm gonna take a spoon. Let me grab a spoon. And I'm gonna scrape some of this out. And I'm gonna put it in my hand. And I'm just gonna rub it in my hand till it melts. It's good for your hands too. Oh mercy, I think I got out too much. So I'm gonna just melt this up really good. And then this is my spirtle. I'm gonna rub that down. Rub your wooden spoons, all your things that you have like this, rub it into it. Rub it into it. Now see, if you make these as gifts, you can hang a little tag on there telling them what to do with it. But everybody loves, or most 99.9% of people loves wooden spoons and things. So I even do my bamboo. I do my bamboo. But what you do is you put this on there and then you rub it in real good. Then you leave it for about an hour or so, and you come back. Look at this. Boy, this one was needing it. You know, whenever you get to looking at your wooden things and you think, oh my mercy, they're starving to death for some love. This is some love, okay? As I use it, I want you to just look what I'm doing. If I think I've got too much to do that, I just put that back in the top of my jar. Nothing goes in this except the wax. So I'm not contaminating anything. My hands are good and clean. So you just want to rub that in. I love a good board. You know, you can make this last. You can make this stuff, your wooden things, last for a long, long time. And I think we are to be good stewards with what God gives us. And this old board I got at a yard sale years ago. So somebody had loved all over it before I came along. Then I cleaned that thing up really, really good. And I love this little one. It's one of my favorites. One of my favorites. Well, see how I have got that all greased up now? And look how much prettier that it looks. Hang on a minute. Let me get that into it. Now, I'm going to... Like I said, I'm going to rub that into it really good, because I use this one for cutting and hot pots and everything in the world like that. I just really do. This is my go-to. Now, I'm just going to set this over here. I'm going to lean it up so it can air dry on both sides. And we're going to let it air dry for about an hour. Take my hands and get ready to work on my big board here. You want to melt your butter in your hands. Then work it into your projects, whatever you're working on. Oh, this one, both sides needs it so bad, so bad. It was when I first got it, it was so treated with great waxes and things, and I didn't need to do anything to it. But I've used it and used it and used it till now. It's time to give it a little love. Well, we will be back when I totally finish everything. Okay, I've let this thing set for, I've greased it on both sides. I've worked it in really good. And now I'm gonna tell you, I've just got an old stained up soft microfiber up. And look at this. Just buff that off the top. Look how pretty that this looks. Let me go all the way around the edges. I prop this up and let where the air could get all the way around it. Now I'm gonna flop it over. See all that greasy look? And look, I mean, I laid this one thick. I'm just buffing it. Might be bored with this, but I'm telling you, this is the life of your cutting boards and your wooden spoons. It is the life of them. Now I'm going to scoop this on down and let that finish drying and everything and show you my these that I've done. They were terrible. This one was so moisture starved that it was unbelievable. Adjust that just a little bit, see if it'll get a little bit of that light out of your eyes. I'm sorry, I'm dealing today. I'm just telling you, we're getting so much light from outside that it is just absolutely shining in here and making my light above me be really, really rough shining down. So I'm sorry about that, but look at that shine. I mean, look at that shine. And my spurtle myrtle. Look at that thing. These things are used in food and breads, and they're used to set hot pots on, you know, and everything. And I'll just tell you, I mean, these things really need a good loving about every 6 months. About every 6 months, you treat your stuff really good. Now, I'm going to push that up there, and I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take my old board here, and I'm going to have to get me a couple of mittens. There is the beeswax. Let me turn off my eye. I'm so crazy. Turn off my what do you call it? Usually I'll take a little, I'll go ahead and show you what I normally do. I normally take a toothpick and I'll stir it to make sure that if anything's not totally melted in there, that it goes ahead and melts. I'll just tell you, I like to run my temperature up from 170 to about 190. I feel like if I've let it stay in there 35 or 40 minutes and it's not melted, that it's time to raise the temperature a little bit. So I'll take it up to 190 just for a few minutes, and what little bit's left will melt quick. So all I have to do is let that totally cool. I don't think it'll almost seal because look, just put it there. That's a little warm. And I'm going to set it over here and move this out of the way. And there you go. Make you a little paper telling you what to put on that. I was looking for it again. Hang on, I've moved my book. I'm scatterbrained today. Got too many things going on today at one time. I'm gonna read this back off to you, okay? 2 tablespoons of beeswax. I'll show you again. My beeswax, this is yellow beeswax, but it dries white or cream color, okay? Yellow beeswax, and I got this from Amazon. If y'all wanna look at it for it there. Also, you use MCT oil. This is a really good grade, 100% coconut oil. And then you use 2 tablespoons of the beeswax and 3 tablespoons of the MCT oil. And put it in your oven. Put it in your little jars. Make sure they're oven safe. You know, you don't want to put it in there in a fine china or something. Make sure that you use your, make sure that you use your pan underneath your little glass container. I left mine in there a little longer than 35 to 40 minutes. Like I said, I upped it on up to about 190 on my thermometer there. I mean, on my oven temperature, I upped it to about 190, and then I let it stay in there about 15 more minutes. So there's nothing wrong with leaving it a little longer than what I call for on the recipe, because this will help you help it melt and everything. And as soon as it's melted, we're gonna set it out, and I'm gonna show you again. Let me grab something. I'm gonna show you what, when it stops melting and it cools down, this is what it's gonna look like. That's what it's gonna look like. I just put me a little lid on the top that says spoon butter, and that's what it is. So I hope y'all get to make yourself some, because this will be the life. I mean, just look how pretty all this is. I mean, just look at how much better that it looks. Just, and I'll buff this big one again, and I won't put anything on it today. I want it to sit like that for a day or so and let that just soak in and everything. So I hope you get to make yourself some. And I want to thank, a special thanks to Kimmy Southern Cooking, my friend from Arkansas. If y'all haven't went over to her page, be sure and go over there, because Kim is just, she's a jewel, and she's the one shared this with me. She sent it to me in the mail. And whenever I got it, I was like, oh my goodness, I've got to make that. That's great stuff. So, just like with your car, when you put on a coat of wax every once in a while, that's the life of your paint job. Well, this is the life of your utensils, your boards. So give them some love. Well, I want you to know how much I love y'all. I want you to know how much the Lord loves you. Sometimes it just run across my mind. Sometimes this is the way we are. We're like an old, wore out, rough board that's had a hard life, went through hard knocks and run into things that we think we can't get past. But God puts a good old coat of wax on us. He loves on us, and He rubs that love into your heart. And the next thing you know, you're looking like you did a long time ago. God brings back to our hearts the beauty of what it was before we got out into the world and done things that we shouldn't have. Or we've run through sicknesses and had hard times. And God just, He just soaks that into our hearts, don't He? He soaks that in, that love. Well, I'm going to go. I want you to know how much the Lord loves you. And I want you to know how much I love you. I'll see you next time, Lord willing.